Okay, hello everyone. This is lecture number 19. So, lecture 19, which is on numerical on a design of screen chamber, that is very, very important exam point of view as well as in some exam point of view. So, in today's lecture, we design a screen on screen chamber. Before that, yesterday we learned about what are the exact theoretical concept and what are the term involved in the screen designing of screen or a screen chambers. So without wasting on time, what we learned yesterday, so today we are going to discuss about today we are going to design a screen and screen chamber. So here are the content of today's lecture, that is numerical on design of a screen chamber. So in this unit we will design a three unit. First unit, that will be the screen. Second unit, that will be the grid chamber. And last one in this unit, that will be the primary clarifier as well as sedimentation tank for the primary clarifiers. So this is the first design of unit number second, that is screen chamber and screen designs. So here I put numerical design the screen chamber of an STP. STP means what? Sewage treatment plant. To treat a peak flow of 100 mld. So what we have to design here for what the peak flow? It's a 100 mld, million liter per day of a sewage. Assume inclination of a bar that is 45 degree with the horizontal, size of bar 10 mm by 70 mm. Bar size are the already given, that is 10 by 75 mm. And the 10 mm dimension facing the flow. Here clearly mentioned that 10 mm dimension facing the flow and clear facing between bar as 50 mm. And the velocity through the screen. So here are the given what? Velocity through the screen. Yesterday we seen as velocity through the screen, velocity above the screen. So here are the given velocity through the screen as 0.8 meter per second at peak flow. So this example was asked in a NSEM exam, that is December 2015, it's for the 5 marks. So today we will design as per this given. So first you can see here what it's a screen or a 3D picture of the screen chamber with the screening or with the screen. So what we have to design here, what should be length, what should be width, what should be net area of the screen, what should be gross area of the screen, what should be gross area of the chamber, what should be a head loss. This overall term today we will design with respect to this screen chamber and the screen. So first step in the this designing, so we have to calculate first, that is net area of a screen opening. So what should be net area of the screen opening? So this is a net and this is a net area actual for the screen opening. You can see here my arrowhead or cursor is exactly rotated here. Is that clear? So this moving of cursor, that is exactly net area of a screen opening. Net area of the screen. Is it visible everyone? Can you visible to cursor moving?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now in this figure, just we want to find out a net area. So I just move that cursor. This is actually a net area of the screen opening. So we have to calculate area of screen opening. So what this peak flow? The peak full flow already given as a 100 mld. M means a million liter per day. So it should be convert meter cube per second. So you know that a million liter per day, so it can be converted into 100 into 10 raised to 6 liter per day. 1 million is equal to how much? That is 10 raised to 6. It should be converted into the what? Meter cube per day. So 100 into 10 raised to 6, this is 10 raised to 6, sorry, divided by 1000. So here I am put 1 meter cube is equal to how much? 1000 liter. So that the 1000 divided taken here. So that is equal to 1 lakh meter cube per day, and this per day should be converted into the per second. That's why 1 lakh divided by 1 day having a 24 hours, 24 having the 60 minute into 60, sorry, 60 into 60, it will convert into the what? It's called 24 hours in the per day, which we will get as therefore peak flow of 1.157 मीटर क्यूब पर सेकंड. दिस इज अ कन्वर्जन ऑफ व्हाट MLD into meter cube per second of a peak flow. The peak flow are the given here 100 MLD. In 100 MLD peak flow, it should convert into a meter cube per second. That will be the 1.157 meter cube per second. Is do you a clear idea about how to convert here MLD into the meter cube per second? In any unit, first we have to design what area, and when we have designed the area, we required the peak flow, and peak flow always in, always it should be in a meter cube per second. समजलं का हे कसं कन्वर्ट करतं? आपण मागच्या वेळेस कन्वर्ट केलेलं आहे एक दोन न्यूमरिकल एक्झाम्पल मध्ये. नाव दिस इज अबाउट अ पीक फ्लो इन मीटर पर क्यूब सेकंड. वॉट वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट हियर नेट एरिया ऑफ स्क्रीन, दॅट मीन्स दिस नेट एरिया ऑफ द स्क्रीन. सो वेलॉसिटी थ्रू द स्क्रीन दॅट इज इक्वल टू हाऊ मच? 0.8 मीटर पर सेकंड ॲट पीक फ्लो. That particular peak flow, there are the given velocity through the screen, that is a given in the numerical example. So therefore, net area of the screen opening required, how much required, that is the peak flow, that should be meter cube per second divided by velocity through the screen. Then we will put the all values. Just I got peak flow here 1.157 meter cube per second divided by velocity through the screen, that is 0.8 meter per second. Then that is equal to what? 1.446, and you can approximately take it value of 1.45 meter square. So here is the net area of a screen opening required, that is 1.45 meter square. So this is how much area we require for screen opening here, that is 1.45 meter square. Is that clear how to calculate net area of the screen opening? Yes or no? Yes or no, everybody?
Yes, sir.
If you don't understand, I can rewind again it. Okay? So if you understand, go for the proceed. Okay, now the next step, that is gross area of the screen required. So previous what we have found out here, that is a net area. So what should be gross area? So gross area, this area actually. So it is required for the screen opening. So size of bar in a screen is already given, that is 10 mm by 70 mm. And clear spacing between bar, that is 50 mm. We can say that is a 5 centimeter. So screen will be collect, and this is our assumptions. Just we have put here, screen will be collect 60 liter of a solid per million liter of the sewage. And therefore, the gross area of the screen required. So here, one formula, that is net area of the screen opening, that is meter square, just we found out in previous slide, into multiplied by 70 mm. 70 mm is the length of the screen. And this is the width of the screen bar. Actually, this is length of the screen bar multiplied by the net screen area divided by 50 mm. That will be the our clear spacing between the two bar. That is 50 mm. That is equal to, so you know that the net area of the screen, that is 1.45 meter square into 70 mm, that is the length of the bar, divided by 50 mm, that is the spacing of the two bars, that is equal to how much? 2.03 mm square. So this is about what the gross area of the screen required, but our screen are provided here, what? Incline same. Is it vertical? No. That is an incline. And inclination is about what? With respect to horizontal, that is a 45 degree. So is that clear? So I want to explain here with the by using the anode. So you can see here, this is a horizontal surface, and this is an incline face of the screen. And these are the angle, that is a 45 degree. So we required a gross area movement of that angle with the inclination, so that, so as the screen having 45 degree inclination with respect to horizontal, then the gross area of the screen, that is equal to 2.03 divided by sine 45 degree. Sine 45 degree, 45 degree is the inclination angle of the screen. Then that is equal to 2.87 meter square is the gross area of the screen required. Is that clear? Is that clear, everyone? Did you understood? step number second, how to calculate or how to find a gross area of the screen required? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. This is about the gross area, and previous slide in step number first, this is about the net opening area of the screen, and second one, gross area of the screen required. Now, third one step, that will be the net submerge area of the screen. Now, submerge is the meaning of the submerge. In Marathi, you can see here, this is the water level in this green format. Madhye dishtay tumhala picture how water chi level hai ani kiti area हा स्क्रीनचा मध्ये त्याच्यामध्ये डुबलेला असला पाहिजे, मध्ये सबमर्ज असलेला पाहिजे त्याच्यामध्ये, तो एरिया फाइंड करायचा. सो नेट सबमर्ज एरिया ऑफ द स्क्रीन वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट हियर. सो मीनिंग ऑफ नेट सबमर्ज एरिया क्लिअर हियर. नाव वी विल डिटरमाइन नेट सबमर्ज एरिया. नेट सबमर्ज एरिया ऑफ द स्क्रीन दॅट इज इक्वल टू वी हॅव 1/4 mL डिवाइडेड बाय वेलॉसिटी थ्रू द स्क्रीन. Is that clear? So velocity through the screen already given, and peak flow just we calculated in our first slide. So that is 1.157 divided by 0.8 meter per second. That is equal to 1.446 meter square. This is the actual net submerged area of the screen. Is that clear? This is the net submerged area of the screen. If it is horizontal, if it is an inclination of inclination, both cases we consider here. And for that, we found out here the submerged area of the screen with respect to its a peak flow. Now, therefore, net submerged area we can write here, that is 1.446 meter square. Now, in the next step, we want to find out here a submerged area of the screen only. What? So that will be the net submerged area. Now just how much area submerged exactly? So just we have to find out here. So that's exactly submerged area we can see here. I just move that cursor here. Actually submerged area. Those who are recently joined, please mute your mic. Okay, this is actual submerged net area, or actual submerged area of the net of the screen. So submerged area of the screen, that is equal to what? Net submerged area, just we found out in a previous slide, multiplied by sine theta. Theta is the inclination angle of the screen. So therefore, put the all values of both. 1.446 is the net submerged area multiplied by sine 45 degrees. So this is 45 degree is the inclination angle of a bar, and that is equal to 1.022 meter square. It is the submerged area of the screen. So therefore, we can write as a highlight here, submerged area of the screen, that is 1.022 meter square. So this is about net submerged area about a screen. Now, next step that is very important, velocity of a flow above screen. Is that clear? This is in previous lecture, we discuss about two velocity in a screen chamber as well as screening. One is above and another is through the screen. So here, which velocity are they given? The question, I'm asking the question, which velocity are they given in numerical? Give me the answer. Just starting the lecture, already I explained, when we read the numerical example, and at that time I told you, as starting of the lectures. So yesterday also I told you, in a screen chamber, there are the two velocity. One, it's a above velocity, and one, it's in a through the velocity. In just we read a numerical example in the statement wise, and there are the one velocity are the given. Is it velocity of a flow above? Otherwise, it's a velocity through the screen. Just tell me, is it through velocity screen? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You cannot able to give the answers. You are not able to give the answer. Why? you doesn't understand what I am teaching here. Hello, unmute yourself. Anyway, lastly, I will ask again. Lastly, I will again rewind each step and each slide. Okay. Now, in the numerical example, they are given a true velocity of the screen, and with respect to the true velocity, we have to calculate here two things. One is the velocity flow above screen chamber, and one is head loss. Now, in the head loss means what? So, true velocity and above velocity. Above velocity means before that screening of a flow velocity, that is the above velocity, before impact of flow on that bar screen, that velocity of flow, that is the above velocity exactly. And when the passing the flow through the screening, that is the true velocity of the screening. And the head loss is what this area where I am moving my cursor, you can see this is a head loss. Is it that clear? This is a head loss. How much head loss should be here? So we have to calculate the head loss as well as velocity above the screen. What should be kept velocity through the above the screen? So for that, velocity of a flow above the screen chamber, that is equal to through the screen multiplied by clear spacing between two bar divided by length of bar. So I put the all values here. That is velocity through the screen 0.8 meter per second multiplied by 50 mm, that is a clear spacing between two screen bar divided by length of one bar or length of the bar, that is 70 mm. Is that clear? So that is equal to 0.57 meter per second. This is the velocity of a flow above the screen chamber. Is that clear? So above the screen chamber, velocity, that should be equal to how much? 0.57 meter per second. This is where I am moving my cursor. This velocity of a flow should be what? 0.57 meter per second. Exactly touched to the screen. That is above the screen exactly, meaning of word. Is it? Now second, that is we have to calculate here the head loss, that is HL. Is that clear? In the HL, head loss, that is equal to previous lecture, I put one formula there. How to calculate head loss. And with respect to that formula is 0.0729 in a bracket capital V square minus small v square. So capital V is what? It's the true velocity of a screen, and small v is a flow velocity of a flow above the screen. So put the both values, both magnitude in this formula, that is 0.0729, that is a formula constant, in bracket 0.8 square, that is a through velocity square, minus 0.57 square, bracket complete, and this is 0.57 is the above velocity of a flow of a screen, and then calculate overall this. We'll get the answer of 0.022 m, that is a meter, and we can write here the head loss is, that is equal to 2.29 centimeter. That means 2.29 centimeter head loss should be here where I put my cursor. I am moving my cursor. So this is about how to calculate or how to find out velocity of a flow above screen as well as head loss of the screen or of the screen chamber. So do you understand? Did you understood? Yes or no? Student, give me the response. If you didn't give response, I consider you not facing or you not attend the video lectures. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, very good. Response from, I think it's a voice of a More. Okay, now this is about calculation of velocity of a flow above screen as well as head loss. Now, next step, that is, just wait for 2 minutes. Velocity of a flow in a screen chamber. Now, just we will consider velocity of a flow in a screen chamber, and we have to calculate it. Now we have to clear our idea about through velocity and above velocity in the screen. Now, what should be velocity of a flow in a screen chamber? That overall screen chamber you can see here. This is a velocity. This arrowhead mentioned as a flow velocity. And this end to this end, this is our screen chamber. Is that clear? And so you now we have to calculate here velocity of a flow in overall screen chamber. Is it? After considering head loss as well as screen size. Now we can calculate through this formula velocity of a flow in a screen chamber. We can see a velocity of a flow in the screen chamber that is equal to peak flow divided by submerged area of the screen. Divided by what? Submerged area of the screen. Here not put net submerged area, just put here submerged area. Both we have calculated in previous slide, net submerged area as well as submerged area of the screen. So that we consider here what only submerged area of the screen, and that is equal to 1.157 meter cube per second, that is peak flow, and 1.022 that meter square, that is a submerged area of the screen, and that is equal to, we'll get here 1.13 meter per second is the velocity of a flow in the screen. So we can write that therefore the velocity of a flow of in the screen chamber that will it should be 1.13 meter per second. So starting from this to end of this, so this is overall chamber and the velocity of this flow recharge should be a 1.13 meter per second. Okay, it's about the velocity of flow in a screen chamber. Now liquid depth. That is very very important. So liquid depth find karna manje kay karna, just to you I am using here one anode. So just we have to suppose that this is a screen chamber in the section wise, and we have to calculate here that is a liquid depth. Is that clear? This is a liquid depth. So in liquid depth we know that here size of bar are the given, that is 70 mm by the 10 mm, and the 10 mm is the facing of the flow, that is clear spacing between the bar size as 50 mm. So size is 70 by 10 mm and its clear spacing is 50 mm. And we assume here provided 20 numbers of bar. Is it? It's here we have provided 20 numbers. This is an assumption and these are the givens. So assumption is what 20 mm numbers of bar we have provided in that screen. So therefore the gross width of this. Therefore the gross width of the screen chamber that is equal to what? 20, that is the number of bar we have just assumed it, into 0.01, that is the what size of bar? 20 10 mm che 20 bar plus 21 into 0.05 meter, that is the spacing of what between two bars, and to one as a consider side to side clear distance. So that 21 as a consider here. If you consider here as a mere 29, then here will be the 20. If you consider here 15, then here will be the 16. So these are the finding out for the gross width of the screen chamber. So therefore that is equal to 1.25 meter, and that is equal to 1250 mm is the gross width of the screen chamber. So now therefore we can easily calculate liquid depth, and just I draw one figure here what exactly liquid depth. So submerged area of the screen, so you know that is 1.022 divided by gross width of the screen chamber, just we found out here that is 1.25, that is in meter, and then that is equal to, we'll get here liquid depth, it should be 0.817 meter. So is that clear? So here we have clear about the liquid depth. Now Now this is about liquid depth. Next step, total depth of the channel and the size of the channel. So provide freeboard. Freeboard means what? This space is called as freeboard. Ja surface la jo varti ka area asel surface water pasun jo varti area asel which is called as freeboard, and as we consider that is 0.25 meter, and total depth of the channel, so overall this total depth of the channel will be liquid depth plus freeboard, and freeboard we have assume here that is 0.25 meter, and liquid depth we know that is 0.817 plus 0.25, that is equal to 1.067 meter, say that is 1067 mm. Now size of channel, that is equal to gross width of a channel into total depth, and that is 1250 mm by 1067. This is the size of channel. This is the size of channel. Is that clear? This is gross width, and this is a total depth, width and depth. Size of channel are the given here. So design dimension we can consider here. Provide 20 numbers of bars. 7 that already given. Just we have to assume 20 mm bar, 70 by 10 mm bar as 10 mm. Size at inclination already given, that is a 45 degree. Provide the channel depth that already we found out here, that is 1067 mm, and the width equal to the 1250 mm, and the provide the screen area or the screen gross area, that is 0.27 meter square. Is that clear? So we can also found here the length. If you consider area is equal to L into width, so width and area are the we have, we can easily calculate the L. Is that clear? But as a numerical, just we want to find out the depth as well as its width and screen size. So also one part or one term add here, that is length, and length always find out with respect to what? Area. And you know that area is equal to what? Length into width. So I'm writing here through the mouse, please consider here, and that area are the given, that is 2.87 L. We have to found here, and previous slide there are the given the width, and put the dot value, and we can calculate the L here also. So this is about designing of a screen chamber. So for practice, we have to calculate or we have to design a screen for the 80 MLD. And when I given on practice purpose numerical, we have to make 100 pages notebook and write all the practice example in that notebook. And when actual or physical came into college, that time I will check it. Is that clear? So for the practice purpose, we have to design the 80 design the screen chamber for 80 MLD, that is a flow, peak flow. Then this example was asked May 2013 for a 6 mark. May 2013 la 6 mark sathi vicharla gelo hota. Magcha 100 MLD sathi ha fakt tumhala 80 MLD sathi design karaycha. Same dimension are the given with respect to the previous example. And next one example for the again practice, that is example number 3 for the design of screen chamber, that is asked in May 2017 for the 6 mark. May 2017 la vicharla gela question 6 mark sathi, design the bar screen for the peak flow of 25 MLD only, and it for asked for the 6 mark. When you design, so here we have take some assumption as per the screen designing, screen bar and through velocity, above velocity. So through velocity should be considered 0.88 meter. What are the you can clear the idea about a previous example, and you can design these two practice example in your notebook. And when physically you will be there in the college, at that time I will check it. Is that clear, everyone? This is about screen designing. If you any query, you can ask me here. Otherwise, you can put your message in the chat box. So how many students join here? I don't know. There are 42 students. I think Mahajan sir has been taken the attendance and put it on your group. After putting attendance on your group, many of students leave that leave the meeting or leave the lecture. So when I take a last attendance, my end, and that will be your final attendance. Is that clear? Is that clear, everyone? This is about today's lecture. Just remaining the 3 minutes of today's lecture. So today we have a practical. It's an afternoon session. The third slot, 2:30. But due to there are one TNP sessions event, after asking to HOD sir, what's exact timing, what's its inauguration timing, if you attend, actually you have 50 student has been registered for that event. So after asking HOD sir, and HOD sir said that you can conduct the practical, you should attend that practical, otherwise you should attend that event. And I will put, I will convey the message, today's practical we can conduct or not after 1 p.m. Is that clear, everyone?
Okay,
is that
sir.
Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. This is a last practical session. So course material I will be uploaded on a blog. And just you can download this screen designing from my blog. Thank you for today's lecture. Mahajan, sir. Mahajan, sir. Mahajan, sir, are you here? Stop the thing.
Huh?
Hello, Mahajan sir, stop recording.
Okay.